हेलो हेलो।
मैं साइन लैंग्वेजेस में बात करूंगी आज।
मैं
नहीं
तो
नहीं
बोल
नहीं टॉक
सकती हूँ।
शो है,
सॉरी,
टॉक शो बस की नहीं है।
दैट्स आवर क्यू देन टू बिगिन द सेवेंथ एपिसोड ऑफ मैड हार्ट टॉक्स ऑन
3, 2, 1 एक्शन।
Thank you, Madhearters, for sticking around and making this possible. We have infallibly done 7 episodes already, and today is our first week of launching this talk show. Sabika, it's a pinch me moment. After 13 saal of friendship, we finally have a talk show. And you know what's worse? पहले हफ्ते की सेलिब्रेशन में यू डिक्लेयर्ड ऑन द वीडियो दैट यू विल टॉक इन साइन लैंग्वेज।
दिस जस्ट शोज हाउ प्रिपेयर्ड वी गेट इनटू आवर शो। कैन वी एक्चुअली टॉक अबाउट दिस? आई रियली वांट टू टॉक अबाउट व्हाई वी आर इंसिस्टिंग ऑन नॉट स्ट्रक्चरिंग दिस। सो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एंड यू प्लीज डू पिक अप व्हेयरएवर यू फील लाइक आई एम मिसिंग आउट ऑन समथिंग। सो the morbidity of our times right now is such that I really think that I would love to watch two friends who have survived long distance for more than a decade just talking like they do, without makeup, without any pretense, without any script. And yeah, I mean, for me, this is what I would want to watch. So yeah, please, Priya, Misty, if you'd like to add why we're doing this the way we're doing this.
You know, Sabika, you touched upon two very crucial keywords of the day. One, of course, is preparedness. Now, how prepared are we? How prepared are we for the talk show is another conversation, but how prepared are we in all for this? Nobody can be prepared, yeah? And the other thing is, communication, you know, between two friends. I have to confess to our viewers, I watched our yesterday's episode on a loop simply because it just felt so magical that Sabika and I are sharing what keeps us going. Of course, I mean, these were our mutual admiration notes to each other, but I'm sure anybody who you find any solace in, you also find solace that you're able to actually communicate with that person. But you know, with communication comes this whole big package of, are we even prepared to communicate in these times? And you keep saying this, you know, kal ho na ho, and all of that. I do admire this whole endeavor of spontaneous, unprepared conversations that we are having.
All right, so that brings me to our, we call it a rapid fire every time and there's no rapidness ever. So let's just call it the fire round.
Or we can make a rapid fire, up to you. You're the game master.
No, nahin hota hai mujhse. Maine confess kiya na. Mere confession ko dilute mat karo. Main bol rahi hu, nahin ho raha hai. So I want to ask you maybe just two or three things that you think have allowed us to survive long distance. I mean, if I'm not wrong, only 2 years of when we've known each other, we've actually been able to have easy access to each other in terms of physical proximity. But apart from that, these 13 years, so 13 minus 2, that means 11 years, it's mostly been a long distance. So do you want to just, share what do you think has allowed us to survive so much and so much more?
So I'm going to address your question with the two keywords we picked on today, preparedness and communication. I think what has prepared us or has kept us going for this long is something you told me or you taught me, which is about holding space for each other. So those of you who know us personally, and I'm sure at this moment, whoever is watching this video probably knows us also. I think we've not been the smoothest relationship on earth. I mean, it might seem like that, but we've had really, really bitter fights. And you would say, what's the big deal? But our fights invariably has been like breakups, you know. And what has kept us going is that what you taught me, to hold space, which is if someone is expressing their dissent and if that someone really matters to you, I don't think people are able to hold space. They want to say, they want to make themselves heard and, you know, say their narrative, clarify everything all at once. I can safely say you're the only person in my life with who matters to me. And yet I'm able to like, okay, give myself that breathing time. I have not been able to perfect that model with any other person who I love as much or more, actually. And actually, that's a good challenge. I know that look. Who do you love more than me?
Impossible. Never mind.
No, but see, I really think that what you taught me to hold space is what has kept our communication going and prepared us. So what also happens is we are not preparing for the communication to go smooth. We are preparing for the communication to break down. And that is what we are constantly preparing for. How about you?
Which is probably why, in a sense, we are prepared for this. I don't think I can say this for any other relationship, but I knew that despite the fact that you're in the same city and we're of course not going to be able to meet, and chances are that you might fly out and I might not really actually see you. I love this phrase, with the same chhat over our heads or us over your chat. But I think I'm okay with that. I think there have been a lot of trips when you come back to Delhi, and I've known I will only get this one heart attack wala surprise, where I will have no idea that Priya's in the city and she will just land up on my door. And I will go thud on the floor and I'd be like, bah, you go, yeah. So, yeah. Apart, like, there have been times when I've known that that's it. That's all I get. You know, these sporadic surprises. And maybe because none of these conversations have been anything less than real. And in that sense, very tactile. Is probably why, you know, it really does feel like staying in touch, because, I mean, it's the closest to, like, these conversations have always been the closest to the actual physical act of touching. And it's making me break down while saying this. But yeah, thank you for literally staying in touch and for touching my life again and again.
We can break down in the show.
They can hold space for us.
Yes, but you know, Sabika, what I heard you say is, when you were speaking, what I heard you say was that we have also lowered our expectations consistently.
I think that comes from the fact that we started with friction. I think our initial parts of the relationship were only and only friction. And I've had some very beautiful relationships which have been very smooth communication through and through. And they have failed because there was no friction. And when the friction finally gets introduced, you don't know how to handle it because you're far from prepared. You've already set your expectations right up there. So whenever you set your expectations up for pretty much anything, you're going to come crashing, man. So, yeah, I think it's interesting that, you know, it's all been like a been there, done that before we even started experiencing the beauty of it. Like, the worst was kind of over. So it was almost always like, all right, even if the worst comes back, we've seen it, right? So, yeah, been there, done that.
And in the interest of time, I would just like to say that if there is one thing you can take away from this video is again, that quote I read somewhere. Actually, I'll tell you where I read it. It was Jojo Rabbit, the film, which says, "Let it all happen to you, beauty and terror. This shall too pass." Nobody can be prepared for what we are all feeling, going through collectively right now. But what we can do is we can go into it more mindfully.
Which kind of beautifully brings us to full circle, because if I remember correctly, your first episode, my first thing you wanted in the bunker we were designing was a glass ceiling, for precisely this reason, that you want to see it all, good, bad, ugly. I want to be able to go through it with sight and not blinded. So yeah, thank you for saying that.
It's been a week, guys. We hope it continues for the next 7 days of the lockdown. I hope to see you on this chat every day, Sabika, without fail.
All right, time to offer some love. Itta sara ikattha ho gaya, kya karu main is pyar ka? All right, I'm ready. Yes, love you.
Yes, love you.